Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Tonya Okoli and I am a beauty and lifestyle YouTuber. If you're new here, I would urge you to sit back, relax, and don't forget to subscribe. So, in my previous video, I spoke about 5 red flags to avoid when dating in your 20s. If you haven't seen that video, I'm going to leave a link right here or in my description box so you guys can go ahead and check that out. And in this video, I'm going to be talking about 6 ways to build lifetime wealth in your 20s. Okay, so how do you actually build wealth in your 20s? So let me teach you. Come closer. The first one is create a budget. You have to create a budget. You have to have a budget if you plan on building wealth in your 20s, and if you plan on having that wealth to last you a lifetime, you have to know how to create a budget and how to stick to that budget. So creating a budget basically means that you plan and assign where your money is going to for the month or for the year. This will help you keep track of where your money is going to and how you actually spend your money. So now you might be asking me, like, Tonya, how do you even create a budget? Where do I start from, you know? Well, you can start by using apps. There's so many apps that you can find online that you can use to create a budget. I found some for you guys and I'm just going to leave them right here. The first one is Mint. The second one is Buddy. The third one is Good Budget. So you guys can go ahead and check all those apps out. They are good apps that you can use to create a budget. I personally use Buddy because it's just so easy to work with. So now that you have created your budget, you need to adhere to that budget strictly. Don't disregard your budget. If you plan to spend $100 on food, make sure it's $100 you're spending, nothing more, nothing less. I know life happened, but you can just have a little bit of money for miscellaneous and whatever, but try to adhere to your budget strictly. Creating a budget requires discipline. And it will be hard, like, I'm not even going to lie, it's going to be hard to stick to the budget. But once you stick to that budget, you'll be able to build wealth in your 20s that will last you a lifetime. Oh. Next one is start saving for different occasions and reasons. Firstly, you have to learn to start saving. And secondly, it's very important for you to save for different reasons. Like, you can save for your future kids, you can save for a trip that you're planning, you can save for rainy days, you can save for a lot of reasons. So try to have like several saving accounts. Don't just have one saving account. And it doesn't have to be like a lot of money you put into those accounts. It can just be like, what, maybe $100 every month, or like $50 every 2 weeks. Like, just try to have the habit of saving. It will really help you build wealth in your 20s. So another reason you could start saving for is retirement. Like, a lot of us in our 20s, we think like, it's too early to start saving for your retirement. Like, I'm still young. Why do I have to start saving for retirement that is in like, what, 30 years time or 40 years time? No, you have to start saving, because if you start saving now, the amount of money you accumulate when you actually reach the time to retire is going to be a lot, and that will definitely last you a lifetime. You don't have to go back to working again or go back to looking for menial jobs so you can sustain yourself. Like, you would have built enough wealth that will last you till when you're ready to die. So the third step to build lifetime wealth in your 20s is to have more than one income. Like, this is the most essential way to build wealth in your 20s. You need to have different streams of income. That is the only way you can accumulate money and build wealth that will last you a lifetime. So you can actually monetize your skill. If you know how to do makeup very well, go ahead and start charging people for it. If you know how to do hair very well, start charging people for it. If you know how to make wigs, if you know how to cook food, like, there are so many things you already know that you can use to earn income. And if you feel like, oh, I don't know how to cook, or I can't do makeup, or I don't know how to make hair, there are 1,000,001 ways to earn extra income. You just have to research. go online, make that research, and you will definitely find one that suits you and that will work for you, and voila, you're making extra income. Another way to earn extra income is by investing. Investing is really important right now, not just in your 20s, but it's going to help you in the future. So try and learn how to invest. Do your research about investing, where to invest in. Investing in cryptocurrencies and stocks are the way to go right now in your 20s. So before you invest, you have to discover what platform best suits you. You have to learn what type of stocks you can actually invest in and how that profits you. You have to decide if you're investing for the long run or the short run. Like, basically do your research and get into investing, because that is one of the main ways to earn extra income. The next one is cut back on living expenses. This has to be the most difficult way to actually build lifetime wealth in your 20s, because if you're a girl like me, you know that we like shopping, we like getting that new bag, new shoe, new dress, new hair. You know, it's really hard to actually cut back on your expenses, especially as a girl. So for me, I have these three rules that help me to cut down on spending unnecessary. So the first one is, how would the product I'm trying to buy benefit me? How long is it going to last? And is it actually necessary? Do I actually need it or do I want it? So another way to actually cut down on your living expenses is to buy products that will last you a long time. So for me now, if I go into the store and I want to get, like, let's say shower gel, I'm actually going to be looking at bottles that are really big and bottles I know will last me for more than a month. Maybe something that can last me for 2 months. That is what I will gravitate towards, because if I get the bigger bottle, it lasts me longer. And in those months that I don't buy another shower gel, I've saved myself some money. I don't know if you guys get the logic. If you do, let me know in the comment section down below, okay? Another way to actually save your money and cut down on expenses is by finding good deals. For example, if you find a product that they're selling maybe 2-in-1, or like buy one get one free, you know, all those sweet deals that will help you save your money and give you more products that will last you a while before you have to go out and spend again. The last step to build wealth in your 20s is to have a financial mentor. It's important to have someone that you can relate to, somebody that motivates you to keep making money, someone that inspires you, someone that you share things in common with. So my own financial mentor is my mother and Rihanna. I'm going to use Rihanna in this video, okay? So Rihanna is mega rich. What I love about her is that she's driven. She loves makeup. She built a whole industry on makeup, and she's selling out makeup every single day. And now she has recently launched her perfume brand, and that one too is selling out. Like, she's just finding different ways to earn more money, and that's what I want to emulate. I want to find different ways to make money doing things that I love doing. So that's why she's my financial mentor. I'd like to know who your financial mentor is. Do you actually have one? Maybe you have one, but you haven't really, like, thought about it, like, oh, this is my financial mentor, this is who I look up to. If you do already have one, let me know in the comment section down below. When you actually find a financial mentor, the next thing to do is to emulate their ways. Like, find out how they made their money. Is it made in a genuine way? Like, can you actually do the same things they were doing, or can you find ways that are similar to what they did to actually acquire your own wealth? So look into that and try to incorporate it into your own life. It's just like you having somebody to look at and be like, okay, she did this and she got this, so I can do this and I can get this. It's just to inspire you, basically. So yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned a thing or two in this video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to click on the bell button right next to the subscribe button so you don't miss out when I upload new videos, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.